Biotechnology, which is one of the departments of Punjab Agricultural University. I am going to tell you a little bit about biotechnology and what is the admission process to get admission in BTech Biotechnology in our school and how to apply for that. The one of the problems which students face after plus two is choice of the subject. The medical and non-medical students always face the dilemma that what will happen if I don't get the admission in MBBS, if I don't get the admission in the good engineering college, what are the other options open for us. One of the subjects which is very attractive is biotechnology. We started offering this degree, we called it first BSc Biotechnology, now we have redesignated it as BTech Biotechnology. We started this degree in 2008 and each year we admit 60 students and this is a 4-year program. Most of the colleges you will see here, the private colleges and other colleges, they offer a 3-year degree, but we offer an honors degree which is 4 years program. This is offered under, it comes under ICR, Indian Council of Agriculture Research. And last year we made a curriculum which is uniform at the national level for BTech Biotechnology. And that curriculum has a very good component of the practical training. So we offer courses varying from to make students aware of the some basic agriculture, then we also make them study some basic sciences like microbiology, biochemistry, which are essential for actually understanding the biotechnology. We also study cell biology, then we go for this cytogenetics and other bioinformatics and all those courses. There's a you can visit the departmental website and see the course curriculum there. But after you have applied for this, if you are interested in pursuing this BTech Biotechnology in BAU, you can apply for it and appear for the combined entrance test, which is going to be held on 7th of June. You can opt for, this is a common entrance test, which is for BSc Agriculture, BTech Biotechnology, BTech Food Science Technology, and integrated degrees in the basic sciences like biochemistry, etc. And why this biotechnology is an attractive subject? It's an attractive subject, especially if you want to go for higher education. If your goal is to get a job after undergraduate degree, then this might not be the right choice of the subject because you won't get a very good job after BTech Biotechnology. But once you have done the postgraduate degree, the master's or PhD, you will get very good job. You can go into teaching, you can go into research, or you can go into some private company. It will depend upon your aptitude. Why PAU then? The question is, there are so many colleges and universities who are offering BTech Biotechnology or BSc Biotechnology, why you should opt for PAU. The PAU is one of the premier institutions. If you look around, is one of the best agriculture institutions in India. The PAU was established in 1960 and we have been offering different courses like we have been offering BSc Agriculture for last many decades now. But the BTech Biotechnology is comparatively new. But our students, they have been almost from every session, 5 or 6 or sometimes more students, they get admissions in some good universities abroad. Some of the students have also gone directly for their PhD degree rather than the MSc degree. And they get full assistantship or full fellowship. A number of students do come back to us for master's degree. And some students in the last sessions have joined PGIE, few students have joined AIIMS. From the second batch, 2 students, they joined ICER, Pune, and so on. So there are students, they are so well trained, they get such a good exposure to different subject content, and they are theoretically so strong that they get admission in very good institutions. in our department, some of the students who have completed their master's degree, they get absorbed in the department itself. Like we have number of competitive projects where we need the persons to work on different projects, and we hire them as research fellows. Immediately, they once they complete the MSc, they are eligible to apply for those positions. Most of the RFs which are working in our department, they are own students, and they get a scale of around 25,000 per month plus HRA 20%, and after PhD they get a scale of 40,000 plus HRA. So that is a sort of, but that's not a permanent position, that's a contractual position, and students continue till they get a regular job or regular placement in some institution. I was talking about why you should prefer BAU instead of the colleges, which will be giving you degree in 3 years rather than 4 years. One of the reasons is if you are interested in doing abroad, the students with 3 year degree, they are not eligible to apply for postgraduate programs outside the country. So you are getting a, you might be saving 1 year, but you are getting a degree where you won't be eligible. So then the quality of the education which we are offering is, I'm not boasting, but it's really good. Because most of the faculty which we have very good exposure. Most, all of us are PhD. We have done PhD from different universities or from some of the best institutions of India. And most of us have international exposure. And the labs which we have, they are world class. I will give you a round of different labs which we have, which you will be work, which you can work if you get admitted here. In the School of Agriculture Biotechnology, we are working on different crops like wheat, rice, maize, different pulse crops like mung bean, marsh, chickpea, pigeon pea. And from the fruit crops, we are working on citrus, guava, mango, and so on. In the vegetable crops, we are working on okra, bitter gourd. And what we do with crops? The BAU being an agriculture university, its main mandate is to develop the varieties. Its mandate is to develop the improved varieties so that farmers can get benefited from that. And we supply the basic information to the breeders for the development of or improvement of these varieties. What we do, we identify new genes and we identify the markers linked to those genes which can enhance, for example, the disease resistance, or which can enhance quality, or which can enhance the productivity of different crops. We provide the raw material for the breeders to work, for the breeders to develop the new varieties. And how we are doing it? We are doing the genome sequencing for some of the crops. We are also working on the transcriptome sequences. As you as students must be knowing, what is transcriptome? This transcriptome is the total RNA complement of a cell. So if you sequence the transcriptome, you know the which genes they are expressing and which proteins are going to be made. And then based on that genome and transcriptome information, we are cloning different genes and doing the genetic transformation. The genetic transformation, you might be knowing that it's done to develop the transgenic plants. One of the most successful examples in India of a transgenic crop is BT cotton. So in this case, the gene from bacteria, the Bacillus thuringiensis, has been transferred into cotton. And the incorporation of that bacterial gene has made the cotton resistant to different insects. We are also working on silencing of different genes using a new technology which is called RNA interference. And we have a very good germplasm, wide germplasm of different crops which we are using for improving the different crop plants. We are also working on some of the vegetable crops as well. And then we also have a very well established commercial tissue culture unit. So we do micro propagation for the crops which are vegetatively propagated, like fruit trees, sugarcane, and so on. those commercial tissue culture plants, then we sell to the farmers, and farmers they use it, they plant them in their fields and use it for producing seed further. So I will, after this I will just give you a round of the different labs. In this lab you will see the equipment which are required for processing or preparing the sample to be used in the DNA sequencer. These are centrifuges. These are big centrifuges which can centrifuge 96 well or 384 well plates. These are incubator shakers. During the processing of the samples, you sometimes need to shake the samples at some specific rotation so that they get mixed thoroughly, or even you need to incubate them at different temperatures. So these incubators, shakers, they are used for incubation of the samples and the shaking the samples. This is a simple 4 degrees, it's an equivalent of a refrigerator. Then this is a liquid dispensing system. You can see there are 96 capillaries, 96 channels in this. This system can pick 96 tips directly from this and dispense liquid in multiple plates. You can see there are 9 places. It can dispense in 9 places one by one. So this is a, otherwise we have to do it one sample at a time. This was quite an expensive equipment, but it's very, very useful. There are many chemicals which are not good for our health. So this is the safety hood, which we use for opening only those bottles which are not very good, which have some fumes and all that. So we open those chemicals only inside this safety microscope, in which you can label your chromosomes. If you label your chromosomes with fluorescent dyes, those can be seen using this microscope. You people must have seen the microscopes in the schools, but this microscope detects the fluorescence. Those microscopes, they don't have the depths to detect the fluorescence. And in this case, you can label any of the DNA with a complementary probe, and you can, this will start fluorescing in this microscope when you see into this microscope. This technique is called genomic in situ hybridization or fluorescent in situ hybridization. The lab where we are standing, this is the DNA sequencing lab. This is a DNA sequencer which can be used for determining the nucleotide sequence of any DNA. You can purify the DNA and feed it into this sequence, and you will get the nucleotide sequence. And this lab we established under a project in which we sequence the wheat genome, the wheat chromosome 2A. You can see different types of microscopes which are being used by the students. This is an instrument which is called inductively coupled plasma, and that is for the elemental analysis. If you want to determine the content of different elements like iron, zinc, copper, magnesium, etc. in any plant tissue or in any sample, you can do using this. The PCR, you can see different types of the PCRs. PCRs, you must have read in your books, that is used for artificial or in vitro amplification of the DNA. This is the electrophoresis probe where we separate the PCR products under the electric ground. You can see these are different electrophoresis chambers. These are the electrodes which are required for providing that electric pulse so that the DNA gets separated under the influence of the electric current. This is a tissue culture room where we grow the plants under artificial conditions. Instead of growing the plants, we give the plants all the nutrients in a media. You can see this is the media. If you put the plant tissue here, this goes into a callus phase. And then from this callus, the new plants emerge. From a single explant, you can get hundreds of the plants through tissue culture. This is a way of fast multiplication of the plants, and this is also a way of getting the disease-free plants, because they grow so fast that the microbes, they do not catch up with the growing tissue, and we get the disease-free plants in by this method. You can also use it for commercial production of the different types of the vegetatively propagated plants like sugarcane, fruit trees, they are all vegetatively propagated. We can increase their multiplication rate using tissue culture, which is also called micropropagation.
This is the wheat molecular biology lab. equipped with the facilities that are required to carry out molecular analysis. This is PCR room equipped with various thermocyclers to carry out the PCR assays, plate reader for Cas genotyping. For resolving PCR products, we have two different types of gel electrophoresis system. These are the horizontal ones and these are the vertical gel electrophoresis systems. Visualization of PCR product is done using this gel documentation system. This is Conviron plant growth chamber, which is automated to provide artificial temperature and humidity to grow off-season plant material. DNA extraction is carried out here using tissue lysers, centrifuges and shakers.
Master student of Biotechnology. The School of Agriculture Biotechnology provides us latest lab facilities to carry out research basically for crop improvement. The research is also carried out in exciting fields like molecular biology, recombinant DNA technology and genomics, and thus it offers research oriented career opportunities.
Hi everyone, my name is Ruchika Chandey. And presently, I am pursuing Master's in Biotechnology here at Punjab Agricultural University. Since my high school, I used to get fascinated about the field biotechnology. So I made a decision to take admission in this very university to pursue my interest. Earlier, I was having very little knowledge about what this field is all about. But with time, during the course of my graduation studies, I started gaining deeper interest in biotechnological studies like genomics, plant genomics, molecular biology, and plant tissue culture techniques. I believe that PAG is the only institute in Punjab where we can learn theory and practical simultaneously while working in the well-equipped laboratories over here. I think that studying here could give us a concrete foundation to become a good scientist. And as we all know that in a country like us, which is a developing nation, we need good scientists who can think critically and work intellectually to combat the upcoming challenges in agriculture sector.